In this demo, we're going to take a look at how you can actually go through and perform a point-in-time restore after an error occurs. So what we have here is I'm in Azure Data Studio, and I'm using a PowerShell notebook. So we've seen these before. It basically allows me to combine text cells and code cells. Now, before I get into it, I wanted to spend a second to talk about the process for how we're going to do this. So what happens, and I call this step zero, is some sort of accident is going to happen. Maybe you delete a database altogether, or you delete a table, or you make some sort of other mistake. After that happens, we're going to use Azure Log Analytics to determine the time before the error took place. Then we can use PowerShell to go through this whole process of restoring the database and checking the new database is in the right state and renaming and then ultimately deleting the old database. So that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to hop over to SSMS and I'm connected to my database and I'm just going to show you this table. So you see we can access this sales order detail table. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop that table. So if I run this command again, you will no longer be able to see it. So the table no longer exists. So what can I do? So now that we've dropped this table, we need to figure out how to go back in time. The first thing we need to know is when this table was dropped, so that we can go and restore to a time just before that. Now, I can do this several ways, but what I'm going to do is leverage the Azure portal. So here I am in my SQL database, and on the left-hand side, I can go down to auditing, and I can actually select my audit logs. Now, there are lots of logs that are available, but I can actually leverage some of the SQL auditing capabilities here to understand who has dropped a database and when it happened. So if I go ahead and run this, what you're going to see is I'm using it on the database we saw a drop table for, and we're looking for any statements that have the word drop in them, and then we're going to return the time along with some other information. Now, you can see this has happened a few times, or I've clumsily deleted this table a few times, so I'm going to pick the most recent one, and I'm just going to go ahead and copy that time. Now, I can switch back to Azure Data Studio, and if you remember, we're using PowerShell in this case, and we've determined the time we want to go back to. Now, the next thing we want to do is actually store that as a variable here called before error time. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and paste in that value and just make sure it matches the required format by PowerShell. So that means adding 12 to this 9. To make it, military time, I guess you would say. And I'm going to go ahead and run that. And I actually might want to put it 0.001 milliseconds before, just to ensure that I'm getting the right before this error occurred. So when I run that, now I can go ahead and run this command. And note that we're using the Azure CLI here. That starts with the AZ commands. But we could also use Azure PowerShell, or we could do it straight from the portal using a GUI. So what this command does is it basically says AZ SQL DB restore, and then the destination name for that database. So this database, it's stored in a variable, but basically it's just AdventureWorks followed by the word copy. And then the name of the database we want to restore, which in our case is just AdventureWorks 0602. And then the time we want to go back to. So this before error time, which is going to be, this time up here, 0.001 seconds before we drop the table. Now, what I can do is I can go back to SSMS and actually refresh my databases. And what we're going to see is that it's in a restoring state. Now, this can take a few minutes. So this takes just a few minutes because now we're actually restoring the entire database back on this copy database. So if I refresh again, what we'll see is that that has completed. And now as a check, I want to make sure that everything's in order before I go ahead and replace the other database. So I'm going to do a new query and I'm going to copy over this query and just see if that table we dropped is indeed back. And we can see that it is. So now I can switch back to Azure Data Studio because I'm leveraging PowerShell here. We've done the point in time restore. We've also done the next step, which is basically to confirm that we have access to that table that was previously dropped. And the next step is really to go ahead and rename the original database. So what I'm doing is taking our original database that has the error and changing it to a new name. So I'm basically calling it AdventureWorks plus 0406 or whatever that ID I had at the end dash old is. And I can quickly confirm that that's the case by going back to SSMS and refreshing. And now I see I have the old one and I also have the copy one. So the next thing I can do is rename the copy one back to the original name. So basically change it from copy back to the original name. And that means like if I'm using this database in any applications, I don't have to change any connection strings. I'm just down during this brief time during the name change. Again, if I want to double check before I delete it, I can see now I have my original database name back to the state that I want it to be. So now I can finally delete that older database because it's no longer needed. And once that completes, I can confirm with a command called azsql database list dash o table. And it's just going to leverage my default server, which is the server we've been using, and list all the databases that are in it. And when we run that, we should be able to see that we just have our general purpose database and a business critical database that I already had before this. So in this demo, you saw how you can use an Azure PowerShell notebook to very easily restore to a point in time before an error or on a database, or even if you delete an entire database. See you in the next video.